It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. Adams from the four. And down he goes at the 25. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. At about the 35. Throws incomplete. From their own 35-yard line. Third down. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. That's going to bring up fourth down.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Everett is the punter. He makes it to the 38-yard line. Quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Brought down at the 35-yard line.
You know, Brad, these big boys, they block all game long, and they finally get a chance to get the football to the fullback. You'd think with his size and power, he'd be able to pick up at least a yard, but no. The defense not only stops him, they actually force him short of the line of scrimmage.
Slides down to the ground. Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way. He's at the 40. And down he goes around the 27-yard line.
It's a great job in coverage by this linebacker. He does a good job of reading the quarterback's eyes and is able to come up with the interception.
From the 27-yard line, it's first down. Up the middle for a nice gain. Screen to the back, no good. Tackled at the 20-yard line, and the halfback's got nowhere to go. Fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Southern Miss could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, and the field goal is good. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 26. Now here comes the offense. And you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Give to the tailback. Good outside run there. Made at the 32. for the sack. Wright is waiting for the snap. He's at midfield. Gets to about the 47-yard line.
You know, a lot of people in college football might find these types of games boring, but you look at the start of this game, this is good old-fashioned football, partner.
I agree with you, Brad. I think sometimes you look at games, and if it's sloppy offense, that's one thing. But when you see two defenses go out and play with a great deal of emotion and dominate a football game, sign me up for that every time.
Scrambling around, and he's sacked. From their own 48-yard line. Second down. Southern Miss holds a field goal lead. And he throws right away. The junior makes the catch. Touchdown!
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
Hits the PAT. A short two-play, 47-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard. So our score, 10-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Gathered in at the 6. And he's taken down at the 39-yard line.
The Golden Eagles really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator, who has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Yardage on that run. Here's an opening. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
He decided to keep it himself this time on the option, and he managed to get upfield and pick up the first down.
He's taken down at the 44.
Too easy, too easy.
And he throws it away. Third down again. Gets hit out of bounds around the 40-yard line. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The kick is up, and it's no good. It lands short. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
Get to that quickly. They'll bring him down right around the 40.
Let's go. Mark 6, 33.
pushed out of bounds around the 37-yard line.
I like this wide receiver a lot. He knows where he needs to be on the field so the quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
Gets him open field. And they make the stop at the 27-yard line. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. He's taken down at the 24-yard line. Flips it middle to the running back. And he's tackled around the 21-yard line. So it's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Kicks away. And it's through the uprights. Stein has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. Golden Eagles.
They found a way to shut this offense down, but hey, it's still early in a football game.
Yeah, give them a lot of credit for the way they've played up to this point. But just based on watching these teams and preparing for this game, I'd not be surprised to see this offense eventually find itself and start to execute much better.
Throws left, picked off to the 20. Tackle at the 8-yard line.
That's the last thing they needed to happen was an interception. They're trying to fight to get back into this game, and to have that miscue, now it's really up to their defense to try to help them out.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
To the end zone, touchdown.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch. That's perfect timing between a quarterback and his wide receiver. He recognized the middle of the field was wide open, and I really thought the quarterback kind of looked the safety off to open that play up to the middle and then made the perfect throw to the touchdown.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 22.
This defense has everything. They kind of have that blue-collar, workman-like approach, but they also have a blend of tremendous speed to go along with that work ethic. And the better they play, they seem to feed off of it, and it continues throughout the whole ballgame.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Here's the give. That's a great tackle at the 32-yard line.
The option is all about timing, and on that play, the timing was just off. That's going to happen sometimes.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end. Jones, back deep to return. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
The Golden Eagles are looking like they're unstoppable right now. They've just exploded in this game. I don't know if the defense can adjust or not.
Well, they have big playability all over the field, and this defense has got to make some adjustments to do a better job of trying to slow them down. I would recommend trying to put some more pressure on this quarterback by loading the line of scrimmage.
Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. Got it. And he goes down quickly. Pulls it in. First down, and he's knocked out of bounds. And that's it for the first quarter, and it's been all one-sided. 20-0, Golden Eagles. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. So the halfback loses about two on the run. From the 44-yard line, second down. And he hits him hard at the 42. Fires out to his wide out. Brought down at about the 15-yard line. So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
The quarterback made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's a great way to make a statement.
He steps out around the 6-yard line. On the delay, and he's brought down immediately.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. He gets out to about the 6-yard line. He gets it up, and he's got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the 2. Across the 30, and down he goes at the 32. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
It's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he tackles him hard at the 24.
Man left, man left. Two down, back 41.
There he goes. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. A nice third down conversion there.
This offense has a tendency to run the football in this situation, as you can see, with good reason.
makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. And he's level at the 35. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's shoved out of bounds around the 46-yard line. From their own 46-yard line. First down. Looks like he flinched down there on the line. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they can just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
They'll get him for a loss. Second down at 16 to go. Ball on their own 40. Nice run there. Quick throw. That'll bring up a punting situation.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on the pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. And he has it on the corner. Fielded at the 19. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. From their own 35-yard line, it's first down. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws complete. He's got room to work. Out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. The senior makes the catch. Knocked out of bounds at the 49. They come out on an empty backfield. And down he goes, right around the 42-yard line. And he is drilled at the 35-yard line. Around the 24-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made at the 16-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Hit immediately. Check, throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Here we go!
Up the middle for a nice game. And he's taken down at the one. This isn't much more than an extra point. It's up, and it splits the uprights. Southern Miss to kick. Jones from the one. Tackle at the 38-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
I don't know what these guys have to do to get back on track, but they need to try something.
Fires that quickly to the tailback. He's gobbled up in the backfield. It's second and 11. Ball on the 19. He's on the run. They'll bring him down at the 31.
Tulane's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Scrambling around. And they make the stop at the 34-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down around the 35-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Right to punt. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
The Golden Eagles are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
It's still only the second quarter. We got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout.
Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. It's second and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Southern Miss comes to the line holding that commanding lead. He airs it out. And he's got it. Going the other way now. And he's tackled at the 47. Nice interception. Too bad they weren't playing like this to start the day.
Yeah, their defense took a little too long to get into this football game.
First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half.
Blue 14! Blue 14!
He's going to air it long. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
And did he ever lay out to pull that one in?
And he adds the extra point. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Golden Eagles in front by 19.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Dueling virtuoso performances by both offensive coordinators. I usually like to give the helmet sticker on College Football Final to players.
Yeah.
The players.
You breaking the rule here?
I might. I mean, sensational play calling by both of these guys with the headsets up in the booth.
I'm sure they'll be so honored to win one of your stickers.
They should be.
They might even wear it on their visor next week on the sideline. But
it would inspire them.
It's pretty nice to be dialing up everything, and it's pretty nice to be in the rhythm and the flow, and everything seems to be working perfectly. And I imagine this is how offensive coordinators go from offensive coordinators to head coaches, because they put everything together at the perfect moment at the perfect time, and you go, okay, that can't be stopped. And right now, that's what it looks like.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here? Got a good, like a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He'll return it from the one. At the 30. Brought down at the 38. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Right around the 40. Catches it, and that's all. Carries the ball for a nice game. He fights forward to about the 46. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Come up with it. That was a huge play because he disrupted the quarterback's rhythm. Anytime you can come that close to picking off a pass, it makes him think just a little bit more.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Yardage on that run. Perkins gains about 4 yards on the play. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Quick throw. Very good tackle in space. Thank you.
makes it out to about the 21-yard line. He fights forward to about the 23. Taken down behind the line. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. He drops it. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47. Down right around the 38-yard line. Now he pitches it, and they're not going to get it. Great stop. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. So it's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. The kick is up. Not a very good attempt there by the kicker. So we'll change possession with a score, 26-7, Southern Miss. So we're just about ready to return to action. And he throws it away. From their own 38-yard line. Second down. They come out in a five-wide set. Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes around the 47-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
In the shotgun and five wide outs. And a quick throw. And he tackles him hard at the 46-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Throws complete. He's hammered. He's hit before he could go anywhere. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's under pressure. He's hit and taken down. The 18. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Golden Eagles lose one of their key players to that injury earlier. Still in the locker room. We don't know the severity, but unlikely that he'll play any more football this afternoon. And he throws it away. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 18. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. Fires complete over the middle. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. He's tackled. 1 yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
We've got third and goal. 1 yard to the goal line. Touchdown. Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
And he tacks on the extra point. Stein is lined up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
The Golden Eagles continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose.
He's scrambling, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line. Throws into coverage, just picked off. Tackle made at the 31-yard line.
When it rains, it pours. Are you kidding me? An interception? You're already getting blown out. There's no chance to come back now.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. Southern Miss with a commanding lead. And he's taken down at about the 9-yard line. That'll push him over the 100-yard mark in receiving.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Looking for the corner. There's another. Well, the quarterback just showed us he can beat you with his feet as well as his arm.
And what a dangerous weapon this guy is.
He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 31. Tulane's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down and they're forced to punt. Or their drive ends up stalling in a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in the game like this. Throw the ball downfield and hope that your receivers can make some plays.
They'll bring him down at the 35-yard line. He's under some heat.
This quarterback is tough as nails. Brad, he's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Passes it, and it's picked out of the sky. And they make the stop around the 41-yard line.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
From the 26-yard line, first down, Southern Miss with a big advantage. Nice run there. Perkins gained 7 yards on that play. Taken down at the 11-yard line. That's three down and one to go. Golden Eagles with a huge lead. Well, folks, we resume action here in the fourth quarter. We'll hope for some action because so far it's been a lopsided one. He fights forward to about the 10. From the 10-yard line, second down. Throws complete, touchdown. Nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And he hits the PAT. Stein has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Jones takes it at the 4. The Golden Eagles have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
And it'll be interesting to see how much fight this team has left in them. This has been a brutal game. Grabs it and hammered right there. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line. He's knocked out of bounds right around the 44-yard line. Goes left and tackled in a hurry. He gets another carry. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. Five wide. Quick throw incomplete. One of his receiver. Makes it to the 22-yard line. Golden Eagles just put on a clinic in this football game.
Hey, you can say that again, Brad. In every phase, the defense has been outstanding. The special teams have been solid. And how about this offense and the way they've executed? It's allowed them to build up a very big lead.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Tackle around the 27-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Southern Miss in control.
Set, three, eight, three, eight,
fights forward to about the 29. Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. And he's hit immediately. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And he's immediately tackled. It out to maybe the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line, it's second down. Southern Miss looking to build on his commanding lead here. Feeds it to the back. Makes it to the 27. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Ball on the 17. One away. 10th play of the drive.
Man left, man left. Four down. Keep 15. Hard shift, 33.
On the run. The 5. Touchdown, Southern Miss.
Boy, he looked determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him out of the end zone.
Converts the extra point. A 10-play, 78-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Jones from the 4, and down he goes at the 29-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here. But that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. 3-yard loss there.
How much going on there? Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on their own 26. drops it complete to the halfback over the middle. Brought down at the 26-yard line. Right around the 32-yard line. And now he's got room to run. And he hits him hard at the 24. Brought down in the open field.
Hey, watch the slip.
Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but this game, quite frankly, has been over for a long time, and I'm ready for it to end.
And we'll take a break while the injured players attended to. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Gets out to about the 22-yard line. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
To his tailback. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 16-yard line.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Looks middle. Got his back. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
A fun week for one team, a nightmare for the other. It's final.
Southern Miss, 54. Tulane, 7. As we finish up the broadcast, what do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kirk?
Well, this rivalry game didn't live up to the hype this year. There's pure gratification on one sideline and sheer disappointment on the other. You can bet that the loser in this one will have this date marked in red on their calendar for next year.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.